Hello all, this is Dr. Alsup, and in this video we will be discussing the inguinal canal. Now, the inguinal canal is a rather complex region, and you can really get lost in some of the details, so we are going to focus on the most foundational and high-yield concepts here in terms of both structure and contents of the inguinal canal. So the inguinal canal is in the general inguinal region, so that inferior portion of the anterolateral abdominal wall, often referred to as the superior groin region. The inguinal canal is an actual structure. It's often referred to as a natural pathway within the inguinal region. It generally is collapsed except for the contents within. It's going to extend between two naturally occurring openings or apertures. So the first, or the entrance or internal aperture, is the deep inguinal ring, which is formed by an invagination of the transversalis fascia. So recall, transversalis fascia is one of those deep layers of the anterior and anterolateral abdominal wall. You can see the general region of the deep inguinal ring in this image. And one of the potential contents of the inguinal canal traversing it, so that round ligament of the uterus will actually traverse the inguinal canal. The deep inguinal ring is located lateral to the inferior epigastric vessels, or the lateral umbilical fold, and we will talk about the importance of that relationship a bit more in the video regarding inguinal hernias. The superficial inguinal ring is the exit or medial aperture of the inguinal canal, and it is formed by the external oblique aponeurosis, so it's in this general region here. Structures that traverse the inguinal canal, such as the round ligament of the uterus or the spermatic cord, will exit the superficial inguinal ring and route to its more distal destinations. The walls that make the inguinal canal are formed by aponeuroses of the anterolateral abdominal muscles as well as the transversalis fascia. And I'm not going to make you memorize what makes up each wall, but one important wall that is often discussed and often comes up is the floor, which is formed by the inguinal ligament. So you will hear of the inguinal ligament, and this is going to be formed by the external oblique aponeurosis. Now, while it forms the floor of the inguinal canal, it actually extends past the canal. So it's extending all the way from your anterior superior iliac spine, or your as-is, to the pubic tubercle medially. So it'll extend past the expanse of the inguinal canal. Another important area associated with the inguinal region, which does overlap with the wall of the inguinal canal, is the inguinal triangle, or the triangle of Hesselbach. This triangle is going to be formed by the inferior epigastric vessels superolaterally, the rectus abdominis muscle medially, and the inguinal ligament inferiorly. And why we talk about this area is that in the inferior medial portion of the triangle, so kind of in the schematic right here, if you're looking down here, this would be inferior medial, right? So this is an area of weak fascia, so an area of weakness where direct inguinal hernias will often herniate into the inguinal canal region, so a clinically important region. So what is the function of having a passageway in a relatively superficial region of the inferior abdominal wall? Well, there's two major functions. One is going to be that it is a passageway and playing a role in the descent of the testes from the abdominal region to the scrotum during development. Additionally, it is a pathway for many structures in the adult, so including the round ligament of the uterus, which is a remnant of the gubernaculum, more to come on that in upcoming sessions, or the spermatic cord. So those are two potential contents of the inguinal canal. Additionally, the ilioinguinal nerve, which is a branch of the lumbar plexus, will traverse the inguinal canal, as well as other smaller vascular and lymphatic structures. Excellent. So that is the inguinal canal and the closely related inguinal triangle in a nutshell. This is your summary slide. Thank you for your time and attention, and have a great rest of your day.